object class, right? So inside this object class we have a multiple methods. So that method we are going to learn that. So we have a method called hashCode method. So what is the meaning of hashCode, right? So hashCode is a method. So why we use this hashCode and what is the use of this hashCode method, right? So you will get more idea about of in collection part, but just I'm going to explain you what is hashCode and why we use hashCode, right? So you know, when you are creating an object, one random number is generated, right? That random number is nothing but your hashCode. But your question is where we can use this and in your coding and in your real time. So when you will go in the collection part, collection, okay, so in collection everything is an object. So collection is a big container and we store multiple type of an object inside this collection. So this is container and storing this multiple object, right? We are storing in multiple object. So this multiple object having the one unique number, that is called hashCode. Your question is, what do you meaning of unique number? So you can go through that any e-commerce website like Amazon. When you are searching any product, right? So you know how many things are there in Amazon, right? Many object is stored. Stored means many things are there, like MI 7 Pro. So when I search this 7 Pro, right? MI 7 Pro. So one object having, you know, one object having the unique number, we are performing this searching operation. How they are searching that, right? So this multiple object, storing the multiple object. So multiple object means we have a one number. So this is your nothing but hashCode. So when you are creating, you know, object class. So object class having the, you know, own hashCode method. So when you use has any, you know, when you are creating an object and printing the value, or creating an object and printing the object value, then one unique number is generated, that is nothing but hashCode. So when you execute your class, so by default object class is there, so object class is there, then what happen? Hashcode method will execute, because object class is by default available in the every classes, right? So when you will execute that any class, then what happen? Object class will execute. Object class will execute and all the methods whatever available inside this object class, that method will also execute, right? What I want to tell you, if you will execute only object class, if you are not performing anything, then object hashCode will be execute, okay? So for every object is a unique number is generated by the JVM, which is nothing but hashCode. Hashcode won't be represent of an object, okay? So JVM will use hashCode which saving the object into the hashing related data structure. Hashing related data structure, I told you, right? Your searching operation. So we have a multiple object, storing the multiple object. If I will go in the collection, set internal data structure worked on the hashing algorithm. Hashing algorithm is working on your hashCode, like hash table, hash map. So we will see in the collection part, okay? No problem. Sorry. So the main advantage of saving the object based on the hashCode is your search operation will become very easy, the most powerful search algorithm up to today in hashing. If you are giving to chance to object class hashCode method, it will generate hashCode based on the address on the object. It doesn't mean the hashCode represent the address of the object. It is a one number only, don't like, you know, it is a address and all. So based on our requirement, we can override hashCode method in our class to generate our own hashCode. I told you, right? When you are executing object class, then by default of hashCode method will execute. But if you want to generate according to the your requirement of the hashCode, then we will override this hashCode. So see, this is the one class a student and we have a one hashCode. So this is the improper way for using this hashCode. So improper way to overriding hashCode method, because for all a student are same number. So here you have did hard coded, so every student having the same number, so we cannot do like that. So we can use like this is the proper way for overriding the hashCode method, because we are generating different hashCode. So here we have a different hashCode. So what is the difference between two a string and hashCode? So if you giving the chance of the hashCode object class to a string method, it will internally actually, last session we had discussed regarding the two a string. So if you will not override the two a string, what happen? Hashcode will be executed, hashcode will be generated. But internally when you are executing, that hashcode only executed. That's why that random number means hashcode was generating. So how to represent to a string string format? We need to override that. Got it, right? We need to override that. So that's why we use this hashcode. So so if you are overriding to a string, then our to a string may not call hashcode. Okay, so whatever we have discussed, we can see here an example. We'll get more clarity. Close all. See, I took one variable that is called your int type, and again this is your user defined class, right? So user defined class, you have to make the constructor and passing this parameter, and we have already learned that why we are using this keyword for it will point for the current object or current variable here, because this is your class level, but you have to initialize this right when you are creating this. If you will not use this, then value will be so null, because that object will not initialize and it won't be point to the this variable. So that's why we use this keyword and here for constructor for initializing an object. Okay, here you can see and we learned, right, parameterized constructor. So this is your parameterized constructor and you need to pass the parameter. If you will print a t1 and a t2, you can see what the value will come. Right, this value is coming. This is your hashcode. And when you execute this code, then object class hashcode will execute. Okay, it is object class hashcode is executing. But here I want to generate our own hashcode, then what you have to do, you have to override this. Now when we will override this, you can see here now it is generating the different number. Before, you can see what the output is coming. Now this is the ASCII value it is going to print here, your class name @ and a ASCII value it is printing here, you can see. But if you want to display this number, then you have to override what? To a string as well, right? So when you are not overriding hashcode, class object class hashcode will execute. Okay, if you will not override hashcode, object class hashcode will execute. Then what you have to do, if you want to create own hashcode, then we have to override this hashcode. So then you can see this number is generating. This is the another example. Okay, now if you want to print that, then you have to also override to a string. If you want to display, then we must you have to also override this to a string. You can see. All right, so this is the how Hascode is working. So this type of the question they want to ask in the interview, but your real time we have a things somewhere frequently using this all the method frequently, or if you are facing any issue, like I face some issue in the real time when I taking the data from the Excel sheet in Selenium, all the test cases having in your Excel sheet, right? Or if you are generating the test data for your test cases, so that data we have to retrieve and we have to give to the browser application input for validation. So sometime what happened, Hascode is coming. Okay, when you are entering the number, then Hascode is coming. So that is the different scenario, but we should know how this Hascode is internally generating and what is the use of that. So what we can do, we need to convert, we use to a string to represent the string format. Okay, so this is your Hascode. Next method is called equals method, very important, right? So we can use equals method to check the equality of two object. Why we use the equals method? We check the equality of two object. So this is the object 1 and object 2. Equals method is used for content comparison. I will tell you what is meaning of content comparison. If class does not contain equals method, then object class equals method will execute. I told you, right? If you are not overriding equals method, then what happened? Object class equals method will execute. When object class equals method will execute, it will compare reference type. Okay, it will compare reference type. It won't be compare your content of the string. It will compare reference. So let's see in the code we can understand what I want to tell you. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so just I'm commenting this part. Okay, so you can see we have a class level, same I am repeating the steps, not a big deal. This is your variable name and roll number, and this is your constructor. So constructor means we are initializing an object, and this keyword will point your current object and current variable. Okay, what you can understand how, like, right? So now this is your constructor. I am creating an object, a student 1, a student 2, a student 3. So we have a 3 object. Inside this 3 object, you can see this contents are same and this content is different. Now we have a, you can see S4 equal to S1. So I store the value S1 into S4. And now you can see here I am using S1 dot equals S2 and S1 dot equals S3, S1 dot equals S4. So we are comparing this. So now what happened here? You can see here, if I will compare S1 dot equal to equals S2. So this is your S1 and this is your S2. Got it, right? So both content are different, then value will come false. If I am comparing S1 and S3, S1 and S3, then both content are same, then value will come what? True or false? Here what the output will come, true or false? what the output will come, true or false? False. Why? Yes. S1 and S3. Yeah. How has coding different? Then what is the use of then equals method? Okay, I will come on that. Okay, then this S1 and S4. So this is the same, like, so the value will come true only because just storing the value, right? So if I will compile this code, you can see what the output will come. All the value will coming false, except this is the same variable we assigned that, right? That's it. But here the question is, the content is same for S1 and S3. Why the value is coming false? Okay. Because equals method is not comparing right now this content. Equals method is comparing this referenced variable right now. Okay. Equals method is not comparing a content of that. The equals method comparing only referenced here. Okay. And every referenced having the different hash code, you can see. So that's why this value is coming false. This value is coming true because the same variable I store inside this S4. So hash code is same. It is comparing hash code. That's why this value is coming true. But the question is how to compare this content, because the equals method, the features of the equals method to comparing this content, but not able to content. So right now what is happening here? Here object class equals method is executing. Okay, so how to compare this content? So we can compare by using, no, we have to override that equals method. So in the above example, we don't override equals method, then it will compare referenced method. Okay, so if you want to content comparison, it is necessary to override equals method. Object class equals method is executed, which is meant for reference comparison. Okay, if two reference pointing to same object, then only equals return true. Okay, so based on our requirement, we can override equals method for content comparison. Okay, the following, while overriding equals method for content comparison, we have to take a case above the following example. So now we have some two ways to override equals method, but I will tell you the simplest way. Okay, so this is how to override this equals method. You can see we have created a method and return type is boolean type, and this is your student and return value. You can see here integer type, so this is your this keyword. Okay, this keyword is pointing your current reference or current object. Here I'm using double equal to, and again comparing this, you can see integer type we have used this double equal operator. A string type I am using here this. Okay, so pointing the current reference variable and comparing this, okay, this class reference object. So now if you will compile this code, you can see now the value is coming was true here, because now this is comparing this content. Okay, so if you are not overriding equals method, it will compare reference, it won't be compare content. So how to compare the content? You have to override this. This is the one way for overriding, and this is the another way. Okay, you can override like that also. So we already discussed, right, instance of will check this object is present in your class or not. And after that, we did casting object type. This object type we have converted into the student type, and we have a two condition. This one, right, same condition I am using here. If it will true, then it will return true. It will false, it will return false. So this is another way to override. You can try with both side, no problem. So equals method, why we use and what is the concept of the equal method. Okay, so this is very important for your real time and interview purpose. So we have another method called, that is called finalize method. So finalize method is available inside this object class only. So by using this finalize method, we can clean up the garbage collector. Garbage collector means useless object. Sometime what will happen, useless object is there and unnecessary memory acquired from the JVM. So they have created one method that is called finalize method. So this finalize method will clean up the garbage collector, means useless object, inside this JVM. So next topic is your string. Okay, so what is the string, right? So a string is a special classes, right? So with Java documentation, okay, so a string class is available in the java.lang package. Okay, string. Sorry. So you can see, so we have a string, and we have a string buffer. You can see, so if I will go in the string, you can see, so a string is a class which is available in the java.lang package. So this is your special class given by the Java people. So what is the string, you know? So when you are writing, okay, so now when you are writing str s equal to, okay, mk, and when we are writing s1 equal to new a string, okay, just I am going to a rk. Okay, so what is called? This is called your string literals. A string is your special character. It is representing like data type also. Which type it is? A string type. Okay, so when I will not use this double quotes, if you will compile this code, you can see what happened. Cannot find a symbol. JVM and compiler is not able to understand what is this. So how it will understand when you are writing double quotes? This is called your string literal. Okay, this is called a string literal. So what do you meaning of that? So when you are creating a string or a string, so I told you, right, this is the special class. So JVM is also giving the special memory for the string. Okay, so we have a special memory that is called your heap and a string constant pool area. So JVM have given some special memory for this string. So when you are writing this, right, then what happened? Double quotes means object will be stored inside this SCP area. So this is called string literals. So string literals means it will get the memory inside this SCP area. When you are writing double quotes, one object will be created, and this object having the MK, and this is your which one? And this S1 will point here, right? So when you are writing this double quotes, then what happen? One object will create, and this object will be stored in a string constant pool area. And this, sorry, this is your S, not S1. Okay, it will point here. So what is the difference between this a string and this a string object? Both are an object. This is called a string literals, and this is called your new keyword. So when you are creating an object for a new keyword, then what happen? So again, I will create another because we'll confuse this. Okay, so for new keyword, we have same, we have a heap area, heap, and we have a SCP area. Then what happen when you are writing new keyword? Then two object will create, one object in heap area and one object is SCP area. Here we have a RK. Okay, so we have a here RK, and here also we have a RK. Got it, right? So this new keyword means this S1 will point here. It won't be point in SAP. This SAP is your optional object. If you will create same object, if I will make it this RK, okay, then what happen? Where the object will create? Object will be create inside this SAP. A string literals object always create in SAP, right? So first it will check any existing object is there in SAP or not. Yes, it already object is there, then S1S will point here. So this all the topic again I will repeat with another example, so we will get more clarity. Just I am going to this. What is a string? A string represents a sequence of characters enclosed with double quotes. It is an instance of predefined final class which is available in java.lang package. That means every literals is an object. Okay, this is called your literals. So what is the string handling? The performing different operation on the string data is called a string handling. To perform several operation on the string data, we have three predefined classes. We have a string buffer, a string builder. So when we don't want to modify a string data, then we should go for a string, because it is immutable. Okay, so a string is immutable. Immutable means once you will create an object, you cannot modify that object. Okay, so what I want to tell you here, okay, so I have created this string. Okay, so I want to print here. Okay, if I will try to print, okay, see, I'm able to. I am trying to concat this Selenium, but I'm not able to concat. So this behavior is called immutable. Once you create an object for the string, you cannot modify the existing object. So this behavior is called mutable. Okay, so here I have written, once we create a string object, we cannot modify any changes in the existing object. If you are trying to perform any changes, with those changes, new object will be created, and this is non-changeable behavior, is nothing but immutability of the string. We will try to do the changes, then what happen? New object will be created, but it won't be referred at reference, so it will become the garbage collector. Okay, so a string is immutable. We cannot change the existing data. Same thing if you will apply with a string buffer, and if you will try to append this, yes. Uh-huh. I will come on that because every concept having the different thing. Okay, I how to use the multiple concat method, right? So this is the a small thing we are understanding the immutability, because in the string having the different concept. Once you will understand all the concept, then you can come in the doubt, okay? Because you will confuse this. So we have a step by a step we will go. Got it, right? So once you will understand all the steps, then you can modify the code. You will get more clarity about that. Okay, because every a string topic or example having the different concept, so we'll get confused. Okay, so here we are learning what is the difference between a string and a string buffer. Okay, so a string having the immutable, but a string buffer having the mutable. We can change the existing object, no problem. You can see. So you are working as a manual tester, right, Anil? How many experience you have? Oh, nice. You can put like 3 years as a automation test engineer, and minimum you will get 50% hike. Okay, so now you can see, because definitely 100% you will get job, and 5 interviews enough. The people who is attending my regular session, they got placed. Even some of the people got job within one interview. They don't believe also. Same question they will ask, same question, complete my complete notes and syllabus, that's it. Same question they will ask. 90-95% same question they will ask. Okay, and also I will arrange some demo interview session before going your live interview, so you will get more clarity how to start your, first impression is the last impression. First they will ask that, tell me about yourself. In tell me about yourself, they will find you, are you real working or not. Only. So few real time question are there, jo that one I will prepare that time, and resume and all after learning the Selenium and framework, then you can start. So just little bit, because we are taking the in weekend only classes, so little bit late, but it will pay off you 100%. Okay, so now you can see, for a string buffer, if I will compile this code and if I will execute this, you can see now we are able to append this, because this is your mutable. So first difference in the string and a string buffer is, a string is immutable. In the real time, some of the place is there, I don't want to change the object, then we should go for a string. Some of the place, because in the string buffer having the different method which is not available in the string, and some method is not available in the string buffer, then we use according to that way. Okay, so this is your so once we create a string buffer object, we can perform any changes in the existing object. This changeable behavior is nothing but mutability of the string buffer object. Okay, so one more question, like we already discussed this one, this case or string. This is your one, actually won't be copy, and second is your. So we have a two object here. We will learn one more thing. I already discussed, right? This is the interview question. Okay, they will ask in the interview. Yes. Yeah, you can write here any content, but here I am comparing this. Yeah. See, I told you, right? A string, you are telling regarding this one, a string s equal to this one, right? I will come on that because this is having the different, location it will store the memory, right? So, we have a next cases, right? In the coming session, now if I will see, got it, right? You are telling this one, right? So I will come on that when you are writing this code and this code, how the memory location is, storing the value. So here, see, okay. So here we will come on that accordingly. So I'm going the step by step because you will get confused here because the string having the little bit, need to understand that. Okay. So here, if you will use this, so here, the object will point in the different stuff. So now I'm not going through this mixing thing because you will get confused. Okay, so I will come on that all the cases where you won't be miss any interview question in the string. Okay, you can give any answer. Okay, just so here what I'm going to do, I'm using this double equal operator and I'm using this equals method. So double equal operator, what it will do? It will do what? It will compare the reference, right? So value will come false. Now what the value will come here? True or false? True. How? I did not override equals method, no. Then what the value will come? But in the last, in this example, we need to override this equals method, right? Then it was comparing. But in this example, I did not override equals method. So value will come true or false? That is a question. Okay, so by default equals method is overridden in the string. Okay, so it will compare content only. You should not override equals method here. Okay, but in the string buffer, in the string buffer, okay, I just testing. Okay, in a string buffer, equals method is not overridden. This is the another, this is the different they will ask in the interview. What is the difference between a string and a string buffer? You should remember with code. Okay, so we will speak with code. Code, if interviewer is not satisfied with your answer, write a code. Got it, right? So now, if I will use this a string buffer here, you can see the what value will come. In both sides it is coming false because in the string buffer equals method is not overridden. Okay, so this is the another case. In a string class, equals method is overridden for content comparison. Have the enough the object are different. If content are same, equal method return true. But in a string buffer, not overridden, equals method for content comparison. Difference method of if the content is same or not same, it doesn't matter because equals method is not overridden, then it will compare only referenced. Got it, right? So it will compare only reference. It won't be compare your content. So this is the another difference. So this one I already discussed, right? What is the difference between this object and this object? So in this case, two objects will be created, one in your heap area and another is your SCP constant area. And S is pointing to Hipparia. Okay, in this case only one object will be created in SCP area and S is pointing to object. Okay, so this one I will discuss tomorrow. Okay, just go through once this above all the for you know once in the string part. Okay, so tomorrow I will take your session 10 o'clock is good, right? So two weekend.